Hello, good morning. A very warm welcome on behalf of Prodigy. I am Rushabh Shroff. I'm the customer success manager for Prodigy in India, and I've been working closely with all the teachers at school as well as Bobby ma'am. First of all, thank you so much for taking out time right on a Sunday morning. I understand, right? Holidays are precious, especially during these times when we are working from home. And so thank you so much for taking out time. And also thank you very much to the entire school management for supporting us and giving me this opportunity to interact with you all. Thank you so much, Bobby ma'am. Thank you all the teachers, right, who have been working tirelessly, right? Thank you so much. So yeah, welcome to the Prodigy Parent Orientation session, right? A quick agenda for today, as I mentioned, I'm Rushabh Shroff, right? That's my kind of brief introduction, right? I'm going to be talking about what is Prodigy, why do we exist, right? How are we helping, right? And why are we working closely with the school? Then I'm going to be talking about the Prodigy Parent Dashboard, right? What all as parents you can see if you have a parent dashboard. Right, how can you join? Right, and lastly, I'll be taking any questions. Right, so any questions that you all have, right, you can just type them in the chat box, right, in the YouTube live chat, and I'll be taking them up towards the end of the session. Okay, so yeah, starting with what does Prodigy, right? We as a company, Prodigy is a game-based learning platform, right? An education company based out of, we are headquartered out of Canada, right? We started in 2013. And in India, we have been present for the past 2 years, right? We've been closely working in India as well with a lot of schools. But yeah, globally, we have close to 9 crore users using Prodigy. Something that which we are extremely proud of, that we have received love of more than 9 crore students who love to play Prodigy on a daily basis, right, and practice maths. We have been supported by more than 2 lakh teachers, right, across the globe, wherein they use Prodigy on a regular basis and support their students in their classes, right, and even by parents who are, homeschooling their children, or in general, parents who send their school to their children to regular schools, right? We have received support from a lot of people across the globe, and that's something that we are extremely proud of, right? Over the past 7, 8 years of our journey. So yeah, that's a kind of a very quick info about Prodigy. But why do we exist in the first place, right? What are we trying to do when we say it's a game-based learning platform? So something as simple as, let me take an example from a teacher's perspective right now, right? See, this is something that even as parents, you would be noticing at home from your own child, right? But from a teacher's perspective, let's say when a teacher is sitting in the class, right? Or sorry, when I said teacher is teaching in the class, right? They get to know if your child is interested or not in the subject, correct? Right from their body language, there are very clear telltale signs, right, in the classroom. Something like, let's say if your child is interested in any subject that they're learning, right? Not necessarily maths, but any subject, right? What are the telltale signs that, probably they would be very enthusiastic and they would be the first people to raise their hands, right, in the class whenever the question comes up? Or in general, they'll be very, very eager. Right at home, probably they'll be very quick in finishing off the homework. That नहीं, मेरे को ये subject बहुत पसंद है, इसका तो homework कर ही दूंगा. Parents don't even need to intervene, right? You all don't even need to intervene. You know that, okay, fine, your child is enjoying that subject, no matter what, right? But if a child is not enjoying, they'll be very lazy about that subject. I would completely avoid that, right? So you as parents as well, and even as teachers in school, there are body languages and there are signs by which they can get to know that whether a child is interested or not. Now, the concerning part is, as far as maths is concerned, actually, global research suggests that students start exhibiting fear or maths anxiety as early as second standard. Now, I understand not necessarily each and every child will be exhibiting this kind of a trait, right? Some of the students start as early as second standard. It may not be completely for the subject. It could be something very, very specific to a topic. For example, for me personally, right, when I was growing up, fifth and sixth standard, I used to be extremely scared of fractions. Like in general, maths I used to enjoy, but whenever it used to come to a topic of fractions, I used to be scared. Even if I knew the answer, I was not at all confident while answering it, right? It could be with your child as well or some other child as well, that they are not necessarily scared of the entire subject, but are scared of one or two particular topics in the subject for which they are like extremely afraid, right? That's also maths anxiety. Now, when I say that, yeah, you know, there is this maths anxiety, there's a different way to deal with it in some cases, right? So for example, let's say even at home or even in school, if you're discussing, let's say the cricket match that's going on, right? Let's say today we have a match of India versus Australia. And let's say as parents, you're discussing with your child that, beta, what is the strike rate? Right? If Virat Kohli scores 30 runs in 10 balls, what is the strike rate at which he's scoring? Right? Or something of that sort, that if India needs these many runs, right, in each and every over, how many runs do we need to score if to chase this target? Right? Some very, very basic questions. See, the thing is, these questions for them, right, even as parents or even in school, if teacher is discussing, for them, teacher and parents are not discussing, maths. For them, they are discussing cricket with me. That match ki baat chal rahi hai, so let's talk about match. Right? But essentially, they would not be able to answer these questions if they don't know maths. Correct. So subconsciously, because right now no one is testing me on maths, I don't have that fear, right? I'll take that risk ke, haan, yaar, theek hai, galat ho gaya, toh galat ho gaya. I'll at least attempt it and give that try. And I'll give my thought process in the right direction. Correct. So that's the same thing, right? What Prodigy does. It creates a game-based learning environment wherein the entire objective becomes playing a game and moving from one level to another and completing that entire story within the game. And while they are playing the game, what it does is it asks maths questions to progress within the game. So even without realizing that they're practicing maths, they're actually practicing maths. And that is exactly what Prodigy does. And it has been super effective, okay? I've seen normally students who answer, let's say 40 to 50 questions when we get from homework, right, from school. Normally, we tend to get on an average of 40 to 50 questions of maths in a month, apart from whatever students practice at school. And tuitions and all is separate, right? Apart from whatever school homework is at, tuitions and all is separate. But if you only take Prodigy, students tend to answer roughly 100 to 120 questions, apart from those 40, 50 maths questions that they have been practicing from the school homework. So additional 100 to 120 questions, just like that, even without realizing, and they're practicing maths. So that is exactly what Prodigy does, right? It helps your child practice those additional questions. And a lot of times they start gaining confidence from this, that, within the game, I got this question, I answered it. Next time when teachers ask me, right, or when I get it on a piece of paper during exam or any other test, right, I will attempt it because I know that I have started gaining that confidence. Okay. If they are not able to answer it, teacher gets the report of it as it is, right, and understands that, hey, you know what, this child is struggling, right, and I need to focus on this child on this particular topic. So that is how it helps a teacher as well. It helps the child as well gain that confidence. And that is how exactly Prodigy works. And that is what students have been playing so far. Okay. So, yeah. Now, coming onto the parent dashboard. See, there are a lot of elements of Prodigy. So there is an aspect where Prodigy caters to a school administrator. There is an aspect where it caters to a teacher. There's an aspect it caters to parents and obviously students playing. I'm sure a lot of you have already seen your children play Prodigy at home, correct? You know that, you know, it may be confusing at some point of time. Up starting mein shayad aap ye bhi soch rahe honge, pata nahi school walon ne game khelne ko kyun bol diya, right? But so what exactly your child is doing is practicing maths, and teacher gets to know the reports of it. But as a parent, right, there is a parent dashboard as well within Prodigy that you can have access to, and you know, you can see the details of what your child is up to. I'm just going to give you a quick glimpse of a parent dashboard. Okay, so this is what a parent dashboard looks like. How do you get onto it, and how do you, you know, get access to it? I'm going to talk about the parent dashboard, getting access and all of that after this. But right now I just want to show you what a parent dashboard looks like. Okay. So once you sign in, right, you're taken to this page. If you have got more than one child as well, it caters to it. You can simply kind of switch between your two different children and get access to their details. Right now it's only associated with one child over here. So it shows that it's Rushabh's dashboard. There are certain widgets which I'll explain, right? There is a something called goal overview, which is actually my favorite part. I'll talk about it, but just a quick summary of it, that what is the progress, right? So the week starts typically on a Sunday. But so if you look at it over here, last week I have answered like 10 questions, okay? So I got a quick summary of, there are two modes within the game, a school mode and a home mode. So within which mode, how many questions have I answered? I get a quick summary of it over here. What are the topics on which I've answered questions, right? And how have I performed? So for example, if you look at it, multiplication pattern for multiples of 10, I've answered 3 and all 3 were correct. Times as many multiplication. So these are the topics on which I've answered questions. This week I was struggling on these two topics. If you see multiply multiples of 10 using grid method, I've answered 3 questions, but only got 2 correct. And complete the steps of multiplying 3 digit by 2 digit. So if you see, you can naturally see that progress. If you look at it, last week I was struggling on it. I answered one question, I was not able to answer it. But this week, I answered 3 questions and all 3 of them were correct. So you can also see that kind of an improvement, and you can see the topics on which your child has attempted. It's a quick overview, right? There are obviously details of all the weeks, right, that your child has played in, and you can keep on going down and seeing since your child has played, you get to know how has your child performed week on week. This kind of gives you an overview of how much of the curriculum has your child attempted within Prodigy. So not necessarily they have completed everything that they've completed in school on Prodigy, but whatever portion, right, is there of their standard or their grade within Prodigy, how much of that have they completed? When I say completed, that they know perfectly, right? That's kind of visible from curriculum progress. Coming to the second tab below dashboard, it's called homework learning. Now, this is something that's most crucial for you as a parent. This is the regular assignments that teachers are giving, right? So whenever a teacher gives an assignment to your child, right? Wo ek doubt rehta hai na ki pata nahi yaar assignment diya tha report kahan pe. You don't even need for the teacher to send you a report, right? You can directly get to know on the homework learning page ki teacher ne jo assignment diya tha. For example, see, ye ek assignment diya hai, it has started on 29th of November and 26th of December tak khatam karna hai. Right, so you see the end date and the start date. Basically, the assignment is in progress. Whatever I have attempted so far, right, I have got all questions correct. Right now, maine jitne bhi questions attempt kare, 100% of them have been correct. But I need to finish this assignment. Jaise hi main finish kar dunga assignment, the status will change from in progress to complete. Okay. तो यहाँ पे आपको कंप्लीट दिख जाएगा. जैसे ही कंप्लीट कर लिया और कितने क्वेश्चन सही आंसर किए मेरे को तुरंत पता चल जाएगा, राइट? और इसमें कौन कौन से टॉपिक के ऊपर क्वेश्चंस दिए वो भी दिख रहा है यहाँ पर, राइट? सो ऑल ऑफ द टॉपिक्स ऑन विच टीचर्स हैव गिवन दिस असाइनमेंट विच आर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस असाइनमेंट यू विल गेट टू नो. अभी आई शो यू, सी इफ योर चाइल्ड हैज नॉट अटेम्प्टेड, राइट? यहाँ पे दिखेगा आपको एनए रिजल्ट में नॉट अवेलेबल दिखेगा, कौन से डेट को असाइनमेंट दिया था, कौन से डेट पे खत्म हुआ था, एंड वेदर योर चाइल्ड स्टार्टेड और डेड नॉट स्टार्ट. तो अगर नहीं स्टार्ट किया था, अटेम्प्ट भी नहीं किया था, तो यहाँ पे नॉट स्टार्टेड दिखेगा, राइट? नाउ ये जो असाइनमेंट था, फॉर एग्जाम्पल अक्टूबर 16 टू अक्टूबर 21 के बीच में मैंने जितने क्वेश्चंस आंसर किया दैट वाज ऑल करेक्ट, लेकिन मैंने पूरा असाइनमेंट कंप्लीट नहीं किया, तो यहाँ पे स्टेटस इनकम्प्लीट दिखेगा. इफ आई हैव कंप्लीटेड इट फुल्ली तो यहाँ पे स्टेटस कंप्लीट दिखेगा, राइट? सो इट गिव्स यू एन आइडिया इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट द टीचर इज गिविंग एंड हाउ इज योर चाइल्ड्स प्रोग्रेस ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर पेज, दैट्स कॉल्ड होमवर्क लर्निंग. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू माई फेवरेट पार्ट, गोल प्रोग्रेस, राइट? सो गोल प्रोग्रेस इज समथिंग दैट्स वेरी स्पेशल टू मी. आई रिलेट टू इट वेरी पर्टिकुलरली. मेरे को बचपन में क्रिकेट खेलने का बहुत शौक था, तो वेन एवर आई यूज टू कम बैक फ्रॉम स्कूल, राइट, द फर्स्ट थिंग आई वॉन्टेड टू डू वॉज लाइक फिनिश ऑफ माई लंच एंड गो आउट एंड प्ले विथ माई फ्रेंड्स, राइट? बट वो उसमें पढ़ाई साइड पर रह जाती थी. तो माई मॉम ऑलवेज यूज टू यू नो गिव दिस एज अ स्मॉल गोल ऑन अ डेली बेसिस कि आज जितना होमवर्क है ये सब्जेक्ट का, फिनिश टू सब्जेक्ट्स का होमवर्क बिफोर यू गो आउट एंड प्ले. इफ यू डू दैट एंड इफ यू शो इट टू मी, राइट, आई अलाउ यू टू गो आउट एंड प्ले, अदरवाइज यू आर नॉट अलाउड टू गो आउट एंड प्ले, राइट? इट्स काइंड ऑफ अ स्मॉल गोल, राइट? एंड द रिवॉर्ड फॉर फिनिशिंग दैट स्मॉल गोल यूज टू बी मेरे को बाहर जाके खेलने मिल रहा है, राइट? समथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट, अ वेरी वेरी स्मॉल गोल, राइट? ऑल ऑफ अस एज चाइल्ड चिल्ड्रन एज वेल यूज टू गेट दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स, राइट? कि पापा मुझे फॉर एग्जाम्पल नया बैट चाहिए या कुछ नया खिलौना चाहिए, राइट? एग्जाम में ऐसे परफॉर्म कर ले, इतने मार्क्स लेके आ जा, तो तेरे को बैट दिला दूंगा या यू नो कोई खिलौना दिला दूंगा, समथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट. ऑल ऑफ अस कैन एसोसिएट टू इट, राइट? काइंड ऑफ अ स्मॉल गोल इट्स दैट, राइट? द ओनली थिंग इज यू कैन सेट अ गोल कि आंसर 10 करेक्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ मैथ्स विद इन प्रोडिजी एंड आई विल गिव यू अ रिवॉर्ड. द रिवॉर्ड इट कैन बी गिवन विद इन द गेम इटसेल्फ, राइट? द मिनट योर चाइल्ड अचीव्स देयर गोल यू विल गेट अ नोटिफिकेशन वाया ईमेल कि योर चाइल्ड हैज कंप्लीटेड देयर गोल एंड यू कैन गिव देम अ रिवॉर्ड विद इन द गेम इटसेल्फ, राइट? तो उनको गेम के अंदर ही एक रिवॉर्ड मिल जाएगा, सो यू कैन डू दैट, राइट? सो दैट्स यू कैन सेट 10, 20, 30, 40 और 50 क्वेश्चन एज अ गोल एंड यू कैन गिव देम अ रिवॉर्ड विद इन द गेम. So that's goal progress. Coming to the next part, it's the report card, right? So overall तो आपने देखा कि ठीक है होमवर्क लर्निंग में क्या हो रहा है या ओवरऑल डैशबोर्ड पे क्या हो रहा है वीक ऑन वीक प्रोग्रेस, बट एवरी मंथ वॉट हैज योर चाइल्ड बीन डूइंग. तो जो मंथली रिपोर्ट है वो आपको यहाँ से रिपोर्ट कार्ड से मिल जाएगा. यू कैन चूज टू गेट इट इन फॉर्म ऑफ यू नो ई मेल एज वेल. आपको एवरी मंथ ये ई मेल पे भी आ जाएगा, राइट? ऑल यू नीड टू डू इज स्विच बिटवीन डिफरेंट मंथ. सो फॉर इन द मंथ ऑफ लेट्स से नवंबर आई हैव आंसर टोटल ऑफ 12 क्वेश्चन, 10 ऑफ देम वर करेक्ट, राइट? सो ओवरऑल मेरा एवेल्युएशन था 83%, राइट? इन द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर आई हैव आंसर ओनली वन क्वेश्चन, ऑल वन ऑफ एवरीथिंग वॉज करेक्ट, राइट? सितंबर में लेट्स हैव आंसर 10 क्वेश्चंस, 8 ऑफ देम वर करेक्ट, राइट? सो आई कीप ऑन गेटिंग माय डिटेल्स ओवर हियर मंथ ऑन मंथ, मेरा जो रिपोर्ट कार्ड है ऑफ माय चाइल्ड, राइट? सो दैट्स देयर. एंड करिकुलम कवरेज, अगर आपको देखना है ओवरऑल कि जो भी टॉपिक्स है, राइट, मेरे बच्चे ने खत्म कर दिया है या नहीं किया है, कौन से टॉपिक्स बाकी है, राइट, यू विल गेट टू नो ओवर हियर करिकुलम कवरेज में, राइट? फॉर एग्जाम्पल डेटा रिलेशनशिप्स, डेटा हैंडलिंग में देर आर 6 टॉपिक्स, योर चाइल्ड हैज मास्टर्ड 2, राइट? दो टॉपिक्स ऐसे जो उसको बहुत परफेक्टली आते हैं. ज्योमेट्री में 2D शेप्स में 4 टॉपिक्स है, लेकिन 4 में से उसको 3 बहुत अच्छे से आते हैं, दे आर परफेक्ट ऑन इट, राइट? सो यू विल गेट टू नो ओवर हियर फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पे फ्रैक्शंस तीन टॉपिक है और तीनों के तीनों उसको बहुत अच्छे से आता है. राइट, सो यू विल गेट टू नो योर चाइल्ड्स प्रोग्रेस एंड करिकुलम कवरेज. एंड समथिंग वेरी वेरी नॉर्मल चीज, जैसे आपके बच्चे का यूजर नेम वगैरह या पासवर्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ योर चाइल्ड फॉरगेट्स योर पासवर्ड, द पासवर्ड राइट दैट दे हैव, नॉर्मली स्कूल में तो टीचर के पास एक्सेस रहता ही है. अ टीचर कैन चेंज द पासवर्ड वेरी इजिली, दैट यू नो दिस इज वॉट द पासवर्ड इज एंड टीचर कैन हैंड इट टू द चिल्ड्रन और इवन चेंज इट. बट लेट्स से कभी रात के टाइम पे आपका बच्चा खेल रहा है और इज प्लेइंग एट नाइट एंड दे वॉन्ट टू चेंज द पासवर्ड और दे आर नॉट एबल टू लॉग इन. इफ यू हैव कनेक्टेड योर अकाउंट राइट, यू कैन ऑल्सो चेंज योर चाइल्ड्स पासवर्ड राइट एंड गिव इट टू दैम. Right. The minute you change the password over here, teacher ke account mein bhi it gets changed. So next time when a teacher checks the password, username and password of your child, right, they'll see the updated password which you have set. So that kind of syncs up. Right. So yeah, this is more or less about the parent dashboard. Now, how do you, you know, go onto a parent dashboard and how do you kind of create an account, right? I'll just quickly show you that. You're supposed to log into prodigygame.com, right? So you go to prodigygame.com and although I've like mentioned the steps over here, right? I'll just show it to you. You're supposed to click on get your free account. Select the type of account. Yahan pe, let's say you're selecting your parent account. You need to enter your full name, your email ID, and a password which you want to set basically. Right? Aapko jo bhi account, aapke details set up karna. In the next part, it will ask you to add a child. Right? And wahan pe aapko do options milenge. Do you need to create a new account for your child? Or do you want to select your child already has an account? Fortunately, our school ke liye, we have created accounts for all of your students, right? Sabhi bachcho ke liye accounts hai. You can simply select my child already has an account. Aapke bachche se you need to take the username and password which the school has provided. And wahan pe aap username and password add kar do. That's it. Your account will get linked, right? And that's it. आपको मैंने जैसे आपको जो डैशबोर्ड दिखाया था, you'll be able to see all of those details. If you want to add a second child of yours, right? So you can do it from this particular part. यहाँ से add child का option है, so you can add your second child as well, right? Or third child, right? जैसे भी है. You can add all of your children over here and see everyone's progress. And as a special, request, because we have partnered with the school, right? You'll find a link in the description of this video itself, right? If you want our help in creating a parent account for you, you can just visit the page, or even if you want more details about what can you do using your parent account, राइट या फिर आपको और लोगों के टेस्टिमोनियल्स जानने हैं या उनके एक्सपीरियंस जानने हैं, यू कैन जस्ट विजिट दैट पेज. वहां पे यू कैन ड्रॉप अस योर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड वील क्रिएट एन अकाउंट ऑन योर बिहाफ एंड गेट बैक टू यू विद द डिटेल्स, कि ये आपके अकाउंट के डिटेल्स हैं. राइट, एनी क्वेश्चंस? आई वुड बी ग्लैड टू टेक देम अप नाउ. Just a request, you can type in your questions in the chat box. All right. Okay, how to open this game? Correct. Okay, see, if your child is playing from a laptop or I've got two questions now. Okay. First of all, see, on how to open your game, right? If your child is playing from a laptop or a desktop, you can, simply type play.prodigygame.com on your laptop's browser or your desktop's browser, and your child can play. If they are playing from a mobile phone or a tablet, they can download Prodigy's app. You can download Prodigy Math Game app from Google Play Store or Android, Apple App Store, and start playing the game. Okay. Next question is from Akshita. She's asking, why are they asking to become a member of Prodigy? Okay. So ma'am, as a company, most of the services are free of cost, right? Even for parents. But there are certain aspects of the game which are paid, and that is how we as a company are able to survive and cater to all the crores of users that we have, right? So there are certain aspects of the game which are members only, which are only accessible to members, but it does not make a difference in terms of the education content. The education content is same for a member or a non-member, but those who are members, they'll be able to access certain parts of the game which are restricted, and they'll even be able to level up faster. It just makes the game more interesting for students. That's why some aspects of the game they ask you to become a member. Okay. Question from Dipali Patil. How math subject is included in the app? Okay, let me just do one thing. I'll show you a quick demo of how students can play, right? Which will give you an idea about how maths is actually included as part of this, right? But before I move on to that part, I think there's a question from Mr. Prasad Reddy. You showed in laptop, but what about mobile? Sir, on mobile as well, for parents, you are supposed to log in from your device browser, right? So if you have a Safari or Chrome browser on your mobile device, you would need to follow the exact same process. There is no difference. Okay. So if you are a child, you can click on play the game, right? If you have downloaded the app, it directly comes onto this screen, right? You're supposed to enter your username and password and click on login, right, as a child. To put it in a very, very simple form, the game is actually a combination of Harry Potter and Pokemon, wherein your child's character is going to be a wizard, and he's going to battle against monsters which look like Pokemon, right? There are two modes, as I said, home mode and a school mode. I'll select home mode and I'll select play offline. Play offline is not exactly offline, away from internet, but it is more or less like, playing without multiplayer option. When they select any other world, they can play in a multiplayer option, but only with their classmates. Not from anyone across the world. It's restricted only to their classmates in their own school. Okay. And any other social networking elements are disabled. So they cannot chat or they cannot talk with each other. Right. So it's not a social media tool that we have created within the game. So let's say I have to move within the game. So this is the monster, right? The minute I go closer to a monster, the battle will start. Right. So as a wizard, I'll select a spell to cast. Right. So I'm selecting this particular spell. It asks me a maths question that let's say 4 into 10. I have to select cast spell. Right. Or let's say if I've selected this, right now it's an incorrect answer, right? So let's say now I'll enter the correct answer. And say cast spell. So it will show me correct and it will attack the monster in a way, right? So that is how the game works, right? That is how students will be able to play. How to open assignment. Okay. So you don't need to particularly open an assignment. See, whenever a child is playing the game, right, they will automatically get to know when an assignment is in progress, right? So for example, now if I select a spell, right, see over here on the top corner, it shows assignment and 39 to go. So basically an assignment is in progress and I have 39 questions to go in this assignment, to finish this assignment. If I am not doing an assignment, I will not see this indication. That means I am just playing the game and practicing maths apart from what the teacher has given me, right? So an assignment will automatically get opened up. Your child does not need to specifically do anything to open an assignment within the game. It by default gets opened up and it's also indicated by an assignment over here. To answer Rajeshwari Dangar's question, yes, you can open this in your phone. If you're trying to download from the Google Play Store right now, this week we have been facing some issues with Google. The app should be up and running on the Google Play Store by tomorrow, right? There is a minor issue that's going on. And so the app should be up and running by tomorrow. You will be able to download it from tomorrow. But on the Apple App Store, it's working completely fine. You can download it and you can play. There's a question from Asta that when I try to climb the Dark Tower, it asks me to become a member. Yes. So the Dark Tower is one of the worlds which is restricted to members only. Like I mentioned earlier, some parts of the game are restricted only for the members, right? Yeah. So that's why it's asking you to become a member. Vinayak says that when I want to rescue a pet, it asks me to become a member. So there are more than 100 pets within the world of Prodigy. And as a free member or as a non-member, you can rescue only 10. If you are trying to rescue more than 10 pets, it will ask you to become a member. Sujata ma'am is asking, it's not downloading. Yes, ma'am. If I'm trying to download from Google Play Store, it, as I mentioned, there might be some issues, right? But otherwise, from tomorrow onwards, it should be completely fine. Mr. Prasad Reddy is asking, sometimes it asks login, sometimes in China, it's not that much problem, but always asks when I exit and all. Yes, sir. By default, sir, the minute you kind of close it, it will always ask you to sign in. It's not always signed in. That feature right now is only available for our teacher accounts. Akshata is asking, so we have to become a Prodigy member. It is not mandatory. It is completely your choice. As I mentioned, the education content for a member versus a non-member is exactly the same. There is no difference at all, right? Not even 1% difference in terms of the education content. As far as the game content is concerned, yes, there are certain restricted parts within the game which are only accessible to members. So becoming a member is completely your choice. You want the link of the app in the chat, right? Just give me one moment. So I have provided a link for the Apple App Store right now in the chat. For Google Play Store, as I mentioned, there are some issues. So what I'll do is once it's back up again tomorrow, I'll be sending the link to the teachers and I would request the respective teachers to share it with you. I hope that's fine. Mr. Prasad, in mobile as well, it's exactly the same. All the child needs to do is play the game. And whenever they're playing the game, right, the assignment will be notified or indicated like this over here, where it shows assignment 39 to go, right? By default, the game will open up the by default, the game will open up the assignment first. Once the assignment is over, it will start with the other questions. So you need not do anything in particular to open the assignment. Whenever your child is playing, if a teacher has given an assignment, by default, the first thing that comes up will be an assignment. There's a question from Sushrut Mittal. When I visited the website to become a member, it asks for too much money. So that's not something that's in my hands, right? It's a standard fee across the globe, right? Right now, you might have to pay in certain dollars, right? I think the cost, if you look at it, if you go for a yearly membership, it roughly translates to 3,300 or 3,400 rupees for the full year, right? That is the cost. Question from Asta, how to become a member, right? You will be able to buy memberships from your parent account, right? So from your parent account, you'll be able to purchase membership. You'll find a buy membership or become a member option via which you would be able to purchase the membership. You have three options. You have a monthly subscription, you have a half yearly subscription, and a yearly subscription, right? You can choose either of the three and become a member. Mr. Prasad, I hope I've answered your question to your satisfaction. As I mentioned, there is some issue with the Google Play Store. Right now, the app is not up in this particular week. We are working with Google right now, and the app should be up by tomorrow. I've provided the link for the Apple App Store, right, from where you can download the game and play, right? But please be patient for just one more day and we'll have the app. I'll have the link shared to the teachers of the school and I'll ensure that they share it to you. So, question from Sujata ma'am, can we open now? Yes, absolutely. You can absolutely open the app right now. You can absolutely create an account right now. Any more questions? I'd be glad to answer them. No, ma'am. Membership can't be free of cost. But however, this is something that probably will take it up with school. As a discussion later, and we'll see if something can be worked out, but not at the moment. All right, any more questions? All right, thank you so much. Thank you so much for taking out time. If there are any more questions as well, right, and if you come across any more questions or something later on, if you're struggling with, please feel free to reach out to the teachers and, I'll connect with the teachers and get a download of all of your questions. And, I'll try to respond to each and every question. If you want our help in creating a parent account for you, right, as I mentioned, just visit the link that I've mentioned in the video description. Just fill up your details on that particular page and we'll create a parent account for you. Right. And yeah, thank you so much for your time. Have a good day. Right. Thank you so much. Bye.